documents. You've got, go flip through with me. You've got a timeline on the Chinese immigration. Then you have document A, a Pioneer Laundry Workers flyer. Document B, New York Herald article. Document C, congressional testimony of California Attorney General. And document D, Wong Lar Chong's letter. Okay, so we have five documents here. Our essential question, why was Chinese immigration restricted in 1882? Tell your partner what the Chinese Exclusion Act is. What did we just learn? What was the Chinese Exclusion Act? Tell your partner. Someone tell me what the Chinese Exclusion Act is. Yeah. We blocked immigration from China, all unskilled immigration from China, for 61 years, right? Our question is why? Why did our government do this? This is what we're going to look into. So we are going to do document B together. So turn to document B. I chose document B because I think it's the most complex. So we're going to walk through that one together, and then I'll set you loose on the rest of it. That document B. We have document B. I'm going to look at the questions first so we know what we're looking for. Question 5, POV. Who is the author slash source? Do you think the author is biased for or against Chinese immigrants? We can do this first because we have the source info up top, right? So I'm going to go to the source info. We should always read the source info before the article. Source info. This article was published in the New York Herald, a newspaper, on Tuesday, November 4, 1873. A financial crisis triggered a panic in 1873, and a six-year economic depression followed. Okay, so what are we going to say for our POV? Who is the author slash source?
New York Reporter?
New York Herald. It doesn't give us a name, so the best we can say is the New York Herald. This is an American newspaper, right? So let's write our answer here. Or number 5, POV, New York Herald, an American newspaper. Bias. Do we have much information to go on for bias?
No.
Can we make any guesses, maybe?
They're probably not biased.
Why would we think possibly biased?
Because if they're talking about the Chinese, they'll probably be with Americans.
This is an American newspaper talking about Chinese immigration. We learned that there was this big anti-immigrant wave at this time period, right? So it's very possible that this article could be biased against the Chinese. We don't know for sure, but we're going to kind of keep that in mind. So maybe biased against. Maybe biased.
Will we write that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Maybe biased because it's an American newspaper during an anti-immigrant era. Alright, so number 6, argument. In your own words, paraphrase the main arguments of the author. So you get the main idea, and then we're going to be looking at key details that help us get there. So let's read through this together. We're going to annotate for key details that help us get to the main idea. So have the text in front of you, pen or pencil in your hand. And you can walk through it with me, I'll tell you what I would underline. Okay. This article is titled Effect of the Panic, Trade and Transportation Usually Dull. What's this panic they're talking about? What did we learn about from the source info? What is this panic?
Economic depression.
Yes, a financial crisis or an economic depression, right? So let's keep that in mind. They're talking about it's almost like a mini Great Depression happened in 1873. So this is the context. The express companies are suffering very materially from the crisis. Underline suffering very materially. That seems very important. Suffering. By materially, what do we think they mean? Suffering very materially. Yes, they're losing money, right? The express companies are trade companies. Trade companies are losing money from this crisis. The southern steamers and the railroads that generally do large business in carrying freight to the west are experiencing the effects of the panic in a way that is proving quite unprofitable. I'm going to underline quite unprofitable. The other details, it shows that they're losing money. It also talks about the railroads and the steamers. So it seems like trade. International trade is losing a ton of money during this time period. Okay, paragraph 2. The sales of houses have not been numerous enough of late to be worth talking about. So there's also a housing crisis happening too. Paragraph 3. There has been a large diminution in the business of importing. What does diminution mean? How do you know that? Yeah, so remember, yeah, you have bold terms, use a little vocabulary bank at the bottom. There's been a large diminution or a decrease in the business of importing. So again, we're seeing international trade is declining because of this. It results not less from the unwillingness on the part of importers to form new contracts than from the decrease on the part of the consumer and the retailer. I'm going to underline decrease on the part of the consumer and the retailer. What does retailer mean?
It's all good.
It's all good. So it's like, you heard of retail stores?
Yeah.
It's a place where you go to buy stuff, right? So decrease on the part of the consumer and the retailer. How can I paraphrase this in my own words? What does that mean?
They're losing money on both sides?
Why? Why are they losing money?
Not because the seller, I mean, the buyer is becoming broke, and because the buyer is broke, the seller's gonna be broke.
Perfect. People aren't buying stuff. That's what he's saying. Decrease on the part of the consumer. The consumer, people with money, are not buying stuff. This is bad for business, right? So it's this kind of downward spiral. So moving on from retailer. In other words, the crisis seems to have taught a widespread lesson. A little economy and less extravagance. And we see economy down below. This means tight budgeting. So they're trying to spend less money, be less extravagant. The country will lose from the depression of the retail trade many millions of dollars. I'm going to underline millions of dollars. So we're losing a lot of money during this time period. When so many 100,000 people are thrown out of employment and money becomes stringent, a drop in the overall economy will occur. Ah, I see something about employment now. I'm going to underline 100,000 people are thrown out of employment. What does that mean?
People lose their jobs.
Yeah. So people are losing jobs. They don't have money to buy stuff. Businesses go out of business. People get laid off. They lose jobs. They don't have money to buy stuff. This is bad, isn't it? So you have tons of people out of work, and they don't have money to spend. Just keep that in mind. And he says the decline in cotton prices has been continuous. Where is there cotton sellers mainly?
South.
Okay, so maybe the South is suffering as well. And the grocery trade has suffered severely in consequence of the panic. Interesting.
Mister, so based on this article, it's saying that like the U.S. is like economically going down.
Yes.
But wasn't this the time when they were going up?
Yeah. So there's in this time period of the Gilded Age, where there's unfettered capitalism, we have these booms and busts. So overall, the trend is going up. But there's a few times where there's a crisis and panic. So we're during one of those times of crisis that lasts for a few years. So our question is, why was Chinese immigration excluded, right? So if we're gonna do a main idea or paraphrase, we have to say something about the Chinese, but I don't see the Chinese mentioned in here at all. How can we make a connection? So let's think about it. There's hundreds of thousands of Chinese immigrants coming to California. We have an economic depression. People are out of work. What does this have to do with Chinese immigration?
Chinese is taking over the jobs?
Yes. Jasmine?
Yeah.
Good. Chinese taking the jobs. Remember, we learned the Chinese were coming to do what in California?
Work.
Yeah, look for jobs, right? Well, there's not enough jobs here. There's a depression. Who's going to be jealous or maybe hateful of all of these Chinese immigrants coming to work?
Americans.
Yes, the native-born Americans, right? The nativists we learned about. So the nativists are going to see all these new immigrants coming when they don't have jobs themselves. They're going to want to stop that, aren't they?
Yeah.
So what can we say for our main paraphrase? I'm thinking, I would say that during 1873, there is a financial crisis, and thousands of people are out of work. There's a financial crisis, thousands of people are out of work. Therefore, competition for jobs is very high. So people want to prevent Chinese immigration because of job competition. So I'm saying there's a financial crisis, this causes unemployment, and competition for jobs with Chinese immigrants. So now let's take 1 minute. I want you to back that up with details from the text. So look through the text, look at things we underlined, and find some evidence that will support that statement. Okay, 1 minute, go.